bad news told newspapers, and you tend to hear more bad news stories about science than good news stories. And chemistry in particular tends to suffer from that. When a new drug is discovered, there's been a team of, you know, a pharmaceutical company working for at least 10 years on that. And when it comes out, it's a new medical discovery. Wonderful new medical discovery. And but there's a lot of medicinal chemistry that went into that.
Yes.
So. I generally, again, on the theme of being positive, I would say I think we're a very savvy country, aren't we, for a science, really? I mean, you might say, well, it's terrible, but where's better? Which other countries have a better understanding, appreciation of science than us? I don't know. No, but it's worth thinking about, and I think generally the public are good on science. I mean, I love the media, and I find papers and all that sort of thing, but the worrying thing about the media, of course, is whenever you find something you know about, it doesn't really make a lot of sense, you know what I mean? And that kind of unnerves you a little bit when you do see stories relating to your area. But on the whole, I think we've got a reasonable relationship. We are too pessimistic, ludicrously so, and I think that's a bit dispiriting. We always hear about the drugs that went wrong in a clinical trial. A few heart attacks were caused by this. Why is no one being sued? Why is nobody losing their job? Let's not talk about the thousands of people who've had their lives saved. And we've got to talk about risk. Risk is kind of important in life. You know, you talk about why people smoke and drink. We're genetically programmed to take risks, and that's why we got where we are. We killed off Neanderthal man, etc., etc. We take risks, otherwise we'd be here. And so, you know, everything is great again. And, you know, we get the balance wrong.
Thank you. Be a bit pessimistic here or negative. Sometimes I get a bit concerned about the way brain imaging is conveyed in the media. I mean, anybody who's seen The Mentalist or a range of programs like that, you know, or House, or immediately rush off and get an MRI scan. It's all wonderful. I get a bit concerned about sort of slightly false dawns. Recent, you know, MRI scans can diagnose autism in 15 minutes. I mean, as soon as you see that, you think, oh no. I think it's great that the media have science stories. I do think both the scientists and the media need to work together a bit more carefully not to give false impressions out there. But I do think it's great that the way the media can tell people what is available, even if sometimes they scramble it a bit. So I'd rather there was too much out there that we get a chance to correct than not enough.
So I've got lots of takes on this. One of my frustrations is that I think that I'm not so annoyed with the media as journalists, and I think journalists often oversimplify things more than their audience can actually understand, and they tend to have a view that you've kind of got to reach 95% of the audience, whereas I think you should reach 95-100% of the audience with the first bit of the article, and then you might lose them gently as things go down, but other people will gain from that. So I think there is some sort of progression that could come up there, and that's something that as scientists we need to help educate journalists about, because they're just doing their job, and their job is not to understand science, their job is just to report stuff quickly, and we've got to help them do that better and do that more effectively. The thing that really annoys me is that if you are to see most programmes where a scientist is portrayed, it will be a geeky person in a white coat, and science is much more than that. You know, science is trying to find out what we're like, what the world's like, how we can make it better, how we can understand it, how we can do great things with it. You know, it's the best voyage of discovery that we could go on. And so to portray us as uninteresting people is so wrong and yet so common that it's really frustrating. However, I would say that, and I have a friend who put this theory forward to me a while ago, and the more I see it, the more recent events have come out, but I think it's true. When Doctor Who's on TV, science becomes cool and trendy again, and more kids like it at school. When Doctor Who's off TV, and Doctor Who's been off the TV for a long while, our country's interest in science has nosedived. Doctor Who is back. Science has become more interesting. And so actually, I mean, because the media is more than just news stories. The media is, how, you know, House and other bits and pieces. And actually, you can present interesting angles. Okay, Doctor Who is not generally real, normal science, but there are still good bits in it. And using that in a positive way, I think, is a really important thing. And so when we think of the media, we've also got to got to have that broad perspective. And I think my final point is that we shouldn't get too hung up on it, because most of us don't remember the stories we read a day or two before. So, you know, we also need to be adult about it and not get too frustrated. It's true, as you say, it's true for everything. If you know about sport, the way they report it is not right. If you know about science, the way they do it is not right. If you know about art, the way they do it is not right. So fundamentally, we know it's just not quite right, and that's their point.